मॉर्निंग, वेलकम टू कॉमर्स क्लासेस एंड टुडे वील बी हैविंग अ डिस्कशन ऑन द सिलेबस ऑफ पेपर फाइनेंशियल अकाउंटिंग ऑफ बीकॉम ऑनर्स सेमिस्टर वन ऑफ यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ दिल्ली. सो दिस पेपर विल बी हैविंग टू एग्जाम्स. वन इज 2.5 hours थियोरी एग्जाम, अनदर इज 1 hours प्रैक्टिकल एग्जाम विद अ टोटल ऑफ 100 marks एंड 6 credits आर ग्रांटेड फॉर दिस पेपर. The main objective of this paper is to have a conceptual understanding of the subject and to understand the techniques of preparing accounts in different types of business organizations. So, it will explain you, the syllabus is such that you will be having an understanding of the basic techniques or concepts behind the working of the financial accounting, and you will also be understanding preparing of various types of accounts under different business organizations like hire purchase, branch, department, lease, etc. So the learning outcomes of the paper are that, number one, after completing this paper, you will be having an understanding of the theoretical framework of accounting and the preparation of financial statements. Like till now in your 11th and 12th standard, you have studied how to pass entries, how to make ledger accounts and prepare financial statements. But what is the theory behind that? Why do we pass an entry in a particular manner in which we are doing? So that theory, that is the principles of accounting standards. So these are a part of your first learning outcome. Secondly, after going through the complete syllabus, you will be in a position to understand the concept of depreciation and its accounting and inventory valuation. Thirdly, we will be learning accounting for special businesses like hire purchase, lease, branch and departments. It's a new, you can say, a topic for you, which is not there in your 11th and 12th standard. Then finally, in the fourth unit, we will be having the concepts of partnership firm and preparation of accounts for the dissolution of partnership firm. So these four units are of theory part of this paper, and the practical part of this paper is fifth unit, wherein we will be understanding the skills of preparing statements through computerized accounting. So we will be using Tally software for that. So based on the learning outcome, the course is also divided in 5 units, namely introduction, depreciation accounting and inventory valuation, special type of accounting for special businesses, then accounting for partnership firm, and finally computerized accounting system. So let us get into the details of the system. Number one is introduction. Now in this unit, we'll be understanding the basic concepts behind the accounting procedures. So accounting principles, concepts or conventions, or we usually refer to them as GAAP, that is generally accepted accounting principles. Secondly, we'll be understanding accounting standards and Indian accounting standards, which are in tune with the international standards, so Ind AS. But we'll be learning only those standards which are relevant for our units in the syllabus. Third component of this is accounting process, that is journal, ledger, trial balance, preparation of financial statements, and then the different types of expenses like capital, revenue, deferred revenue expenses, as well as incomes. Next component is preparation of financial statements of a profit-making sole proprietorship firm. So sole proprietorship firms, trading in profit and loss account and balance sheet making is a component in this unit. Finally, it will be having preparation of financial statements of NPOs. In your 12th standard, you have studied preparation of financial statements of the sole proprietorship businesses and of NPOs. So we'll be building upon that knowledge. So keeping that knowledge as a base, we'll be introducing some more adjustments, some more type of problems. So base will be widened in the syllabus of financial accounting. Next unit is depreciation accounting and inventory valuation. So it will be having 2 components, as the name says. Number one is depreciation accounting. So we'll be studying the meaning of depreciation, depletion and amortization, objectives and methods of depreciation. We have 2 methods in this syllabus, straight line and diminishing balance method, then accounting for change in method along with the relevant standard AS 10 will be studied. Second component is inventory valuation. So we'll be studying what is meant by inventories, what is its importance, and why do we value inventories, what are the inventory recording systems, and what are the methods of inventory valuation along with the relevant standard AS2. Third unit is special type of accounting. This is a very broad unit including 4 components and it has more weightage in your exams also. You have 2 questions coming from this chapter. Now this includes higher purchase accounting. So we will be working for higher purchase transactions of large and small value items. However, the detailed components or contents of the chapters will be given to you as and when we start the chapter. Alright, so right now just get to know what is included in this. So accounting for lease, its concept, classification, simple problems, accounting for branches. Foreign branches are not there in our course, so we'll be working for only Indian branches, both the categories dependent and independent branches with the stated methods. Finally, departmental accounting. So you will be having concept, type of departments and basis of allocation of expenses over the departments. Okay, so these will be there in the special types of accounting. Our fourth unit is accounting for partnership firm. Now, partnership firm is a topic that you have studied in detail in your 12th standard, right? So, all of this is included in this syllabus with some more depth. So, you will be having partnership accounts, fundamentals, admission, retirement and death. But we are to study this as an overview only. So, not much is asked in the syllabus from this. Next is accounting for dissolution of partnership firm. So, this will be including insolvency of the partners and of the firm and gradual realization of assets and piecemeal payment of the liabilities. Like in case of dissolution, in your 12th standard, you have studied simple dissolution problems. But now we will be having more depth into the topic by including insolvency and piecemeal distribution method. So, these are all 4 theory components of our syllabus. Now, coming to the last unit, which is the practical part, computerized accounting system, wherein you will be studying preparation of accounts using some accounting software like Tally. Now, we'll be understanding how to create a company, how to configure and make the settings in the system, then creating ledgers, their groups, creating stock items, right? Voucher entry, and then generating reports. And see, in case of computerized accounting systems, generation of reports is just at the click of a button. But all the previous parts are very important. Creating a company, creating ledgers, creating groups and making the entry. Once entry is done, the system takes care of everything else. So, reports generation, you will be finding it is much more easier as compared to what we do when we are actually creating reports on paper, right? Then you have selecting and shutting a company out of the various companies that you might have loaded on your software, and then backup and restore, which is an important part of your working under computerized systems. We need to have a backup of the work. So, how to keep it and how to restore the data, that will be studied. Now, this is an important component having 20 marks in your examination. Now, these are some of the books which are given in the Delhi University website. So, you can have a reading of these books and you can follow any book which you think fit, right? Additional resources are also there which are foreign author books. So, you can have a reading of these to increase your knowledge of this subject. Now, assessment is twofold. Number one is for the successful completion of the work, you will be granted 6 credit hours in all, 4 for the lectures, 1 for the lab and 1 for the tutorial. Your examination is of 100 marks. Your theory is of 80 marks from unit 1 to 4 and your practical is of unit 5 for 20 marks. So, let us dwell into the components in detail. Now, assessment of theory part, that is unit 1 to 4, it will be including a semester exam, end exam of 55 marks, it will be of 2.5 hours. Please remember, all other papers are of 3 hours. So, sometimes students think that this paper will be of 3 hours and accordingly they practice the questions. But remember, it's 80 marks examination in all, having 55 marks from the end semester exam, it will be of 2.5 hours only. So, you are to practice your papers and questions within this time. Second component is of 25 marks of internal assessment. Till now, we are having 5 marks for the attendance, 10 for the assignment, and 10 for the projects. So, this way your 25 marks will be covered along with 55 marks of end exam, in all 80 marks for unit 1 to 4. Now, your theory exam will be having 5 questions in your paper. So, this is your paper structure. You can see from unit 1, that is introduction, you will be having 2 questions. Part A will be a theory of 5 marks with internal choice only. Part B will be a practical, and you will be having a choice between sole proprietorship and NPO. So, this is again an internal choice. So, one question will be from sole proprietorship's financial statements, another will be from NPO, and you are to solve one of these having 10 marks in all. Question second is from unit 2, and it says depreciation and inventory. That is, each question will be of 2 parts. First part will be depreciation, second part will be inventory, and these will be carrying weightage of 6 and 4 marks respectively. Then your third unit will be having weightage for 2 questions, question third and question fourth. Question third will be having hire, purchase and lease with internal choice. Again, remember, it is hire, purchase and lease. So, there is not a choice between hire, purchase and lease. You will be given both the questions, part A and part B, with weightage of 7 and 3 marks respectively. Okay, now in hire purchase, emphasis will be on the large value items, and in lease, we'll be having simple problems only right now. Next is unit 3, question number 4, which is having branch accounting and departmental accounting, 7 plus 3 marks is the weightage of each and every topic. So, branch accounting 7 marks, departmental accounting 3 marks. Again, internal choice only. Then partnership with the focus on dissolution. So, you will be having major question, major part from dissolution of partnership firms of 10 marks. Alright, so this is how your paper is framed. You have in all 5 questions. First question is of 15 marks. Remaining 3 questions, 4 questions are of 10 marks each. You have a practical component also. And please remember, your practical exam usually is held before the theory exam. So, when your semester is going to end, at the end of the semester, you will first be having the practical exam, and later on dates of theory exams are given. All right. Now, let us see the components. Your practical exam is of 20 marks. It is a 1-hour exam, which is usually taken in the lab. And the marks are allocated for various activities like machine handling, company creation, creation of groups and ledgers, and then voucher entries. 15 entries are usually there. So, you should prepare to solve a question involving minimum 15 entries in the for the final exams. All right. Then exporting of the reports, and finally a total of 20 marks is assigned like this. So, each and every activity has marks assigned for the same. So, this is how your whole syllabus will be covered in the exams. So, I hope you have understood the basic components of your syllabus, your assessment procedure, your paper pattern, and your practical exam. Alright, so that is end of the day, and next time we'll be starting with the chapters one by one. Thank you.